If it's odd and it's not the last ID, then we have to increase. So Abbott became from ID number 1 to ID number 2, then please, lead code gods, grant me safe passage on this Amazon technical interview. Okay.
Can you see me okay? Hi.
Hi. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for making the time today. We're gonna jump straight into it, so.
Sure, let's just get started.
What I wanted to start going over is the premise. So this is about Mary. She's a teacher in middle school. And she has a table, seat, storing students' names and their corresponding seat ID.
Okay.
The column ID is a continuous increment, and Mary wants to change seats for the adjacent students. So can you write a SQL query to output the result for Mary?
Okay.
You can just take as long as you need.
So, first thing I'm going to think of is what kind of subquery do I want to arrive at first? The subquery that I think I'm going to arrive at is I need to take account of all of the student IDs, because what I want to do is offset odd number IDs and add one, and then even number IDs and then subtract one. This makes sense if there are only two students, for example. The number one student would become number two, and then the number two student would become number one. Now, this is a little tricky if you are the last student. If you're the last student, then you don't get to move. For example, if there's 1, 2, 3, we would swap 1 and 2, but then 3 would be the last student still. So in that case, I think I have a good understanding of where to start. My subquery is going to be a count of all students, so I have that number ready. And then I'm going to build a case when the ID is odd, then we will add 1 to the ID unless it equals the count of all student IDs, in which case it means it's the last one. In that case, we keep it where it is, at the last place. If it's even, then it doesn't matter if it's the last place. All we need to do is subtract 1. So I think I'm going to start preparing that. Does that sound okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me start preparing the code. So it seems like we have this table and we want to output this table. The first thing I'm noticing is that everyone who is odd shifts up one ID value. So Abbott over here at 1 goes up one value to 2. And then everyone who is at an even ID goes down one value. So Doris goes down to Abbott's ID number, which is 1. Except if the last person is odd. It looks like James does not move because there's no one to switch with. That makes sense. So the first thing I want to start building for this table is a subquery that I'm going to call total counts. And the reason for that, I'm going to need to know how many IDs are in this table. If there is an odd number of IDs, then we need to make sure we don't switch that ID. And the way that I want to build out that logic is somewhere along the lines of select count star from table. And in this case, the table is seat. And this is assuming that there's only one distinct ID per student. So I'm gonna go off of that assumption and I'm gonna call that TC. And it's gonna have nothing else because all I'm looking for is one final number. And this for that above table would be 5. And I would use this to measure up against whether or not the current ID that I'm iterating through is going to be the last ID. Okay, so let's start building actual code. Select starting with a case statement. So this case when, and the first when is going to be if it is an odd ID that is the last odd ID. So in that case, we would use the mod function here, and we would take the ID and test if it's even. Bang equals means not equal to zero. In that case, there would be an odd ID. We also need to make sure and that it's not the last one. So let's assume that we built out this subquery. I'm gonna have this column be called TC. So the ID equals TC. Then it's odd, it's the last value, which means we don't flip it. We keep it as ID. The second case statement is if it's odd and it's not the last ID, then we have to increase. So Abbott became from ID number 1 to ID number 2, then they are going to be ID plus 1. That's whatever their ID was plus 1, so 1 becomes 2. Finally, there's an else condition. That is, if they are an even ID, then we would want them to be ID minus 1. So Doris up here, who had an even ID, would become 1. That is exactly her old ID, 2 minus 1. So there we go. Close this up and give it an alias. So I'm going to put it in parentheses, and I'm going to call it as ID. Okay. And let's not forget that these students have names. So let's give it student as the second column that we want to select. And then from the good old table seat. And I'm going to give it a comma because here's the time for our subquery. This subquery would be the select count star from seat, right? And give it the alias that I said I was going to give it as TC, right? And then we can call this table anything we want. Let's call it total counts, like we set up here. So that's the table that we aforementioned, and now we have built it down here as a subquery. Okay, finally, we need to make sure that they're ordered, because right now each ID is swapped. It's going to go like, it's still going to have the same student order, but the IDs are all going to be mismatched. So we have to order by ID. All right, I think that looks good. Let's run it. Okay, looks like it's working good. And submitted memory usage less than 100% of MySQL online submissions. I think we have an answer here.
Well, that's great. That's all we needed today.
Thanks so much for your time.
So last thing I wanted to understand is if this skit made you laugh at all, I think you owe it to the creator of this sketch to drop a like. You don't even have to smash the like button. You can just tap it nice and gently. And if this would be helpful to anybody else, go ahead and share it with a friend, share it with a family member, share it with an enemy. Until next time, peace.